It's hard to believe Nirvana's breakout album was exactly 20 years ago. Nevermind wasn't just another rock album, it redefined the genre. Nearly as famous as the music was the album cover, a naked baby in a swimming pool with a dollar bill on a hook. That baby is Spencer Eldon. He's all grown up now. On this, the 20th anniversary of Nevermind, I asked Spencer what it was like to be the Nirvana baby.
Today, we're talking about the Nirvana baby being a big baby and suing Nirvana over the Nevermind album cover. I don't know if this is going to be a helpful breakdown or a just flat-out rant about how much I hate this lawsuit. Hopefully, there's some information you will learn. Nudity does not equal a legal issue. So,
the man who appeared as the naked baby on the cover of Nirvana's famous Nevermind album has now filed a lawsuit. Spencer Eldon, who is now 30 years old, claims that the nude image of the baby from 1991 constitutes child pornography.
It's a trip. There's a lot of people that have seen my baby penis as a baby. I went to a baseball game on opening day at the Dodgers, and I was looking out at all the people, and I was like, had a moment where I was like, man, all of these people have seen my baby penis when I was a baby. So it's pretty crazy.
There's a guy named Spencer Eldon, and you have no clue who he is. If you met him as an adult, you would have no idea. He might have walked by you at some point and you didn't know. But as a baby, he was very, very popular, or at least people recognized his photo as a child naked, swimming toward a $1 bill on a fish hook, because he was the child in the very iconic Nirvana album from 1991 called Nevermind. He was on the cover. And now he's suing under this ludicrous position that it was child pornography and child sexual exploitation. It was neither. This appears to be a lawsuit that's just about trying to get some money. Now, according to the reports, his attorney claims that Kurt Cobain, quote, chose the image depicting Spencer like a sex worker, grabbing for a dollar bill that is positioned dangling from a fish hook in front of Eldon's nude body with his penis explicitly displayed. Now, according to the court documents, the band, quote, commercially marketed Spencer's child pornography and leveraged the shocking nature of his image to promote themselves and their music at his expense. Now, of course, there wasn't any actual expense that was done to him. He's not a victim of any sort of sexual exploitation by any reasonable definition. None whatsoever. In fact, the breaking news is that Kurt Cobain resurrected himself to call this lawsuit frivolous, which is what it appears to be.
Now comes the pertinent part, in my opinion, is that Nirvana profited. They made a lot of money. They sold a lot of albums. And that is why I think Spencer is going after Nirvana right now. He wants a piece of the pie. He probably has seen his life not go the way he wants it to go. And he looks at this as an opportunity for money. That's my guess. I don't know that to be true. I'm just assuming based on what I've read in the complaint.
In Beverly Hills, a 1 p.m. curfew went into effect today, all part of an effort to prevent some of the looting and violence that happened in locations around Los Angeles, particularly in areas that have come to symbolize the difference between the haves and the have-nots.
They are eternal victims. It feels good to be a victim. It's morally upright. If you're a victim, you have automatic rights and no obligations. If you're a victim, you can do anything you want because you have been victimized. It's a psychopathic stance. Psychopaths and narcissists like to claim and pretend that they are victims. They truly believe it, actually. There has been a series of studies in the past 2 years that have demonstrated conclusively that people who are eternal victims, people whose identity is victimhood, and activists in victimhood movements are actually psychopaths and narcissists.
Aerial shots show looters pouring out of Santa Monica Place Mall. One street over, I spotted people casually strolling with allegedly stolen goods. This guy proudly showed off his box to me. And this disturbing footage shows a man using an aerosol can to torch a San Bernardino DMV. Today, I'm getting an up-close look inside a CVS that's utterly trashed.
Sexual assault and rape are the only crimes in our statutes where we can walk into a police station and say, I was raped and someone believed me. And that's it. That's all you have to say.
The lawyer sympathizes with men accused of rape in this day and age, claiming it's become so hard for them to prove consent.
And I mean, people laugh at me all the time when I'm the one that says if I was a man in today's world, I'd make people sign consent forms. You know, record consent on your phone. We want to have it both ways, and we also want to live in a world where men take on all the risk and women do as women want to do, and then at the end we say, well, we have to believe all women. How is that a just, fair system for either side?
A highly anticipated address tonight from the head of a St. Louis County school district. Good evening. I'm Paige Holsey in for Samantha Jones.
And I'm Corey Stark. The Parkway District held its first meeting since racist graffiti was found inside bathrooms at two of its high schools. An investigation has since revealed at least one was done by a black student.
Do you feel like the reaction would have been different if it had been a white student, in fact?
I agree. I think I think specifically the district thinks, oh, because it was a black student, this event is over. Or this event doesn't matter, per se.
Can anyone tell me why we keep falling for this? The same charade over and over again. Thought we learned our lesson by now, but apparently not. If you have to fabricate an example of racism against you, it's probably not as big of a problem in your life as you'd like to think.
I'm Spencer Eldon. That's my baby penis. I'm on the cover of the Nirvana album.